Wow, this is so difficult to turn. It's impossible. The power is on, the engine is running, so the power steering pump may have a problem.
The old pump from BBB Industry, which I used to replace the factory pump 5 years ago, it has lasted for over 45,000 miles. But recently I noticed the steering is heavy, especially in the morning. Two flex tubes getting in the way, and we are going to detach them from the bracket so they will come loose and we have better access to the steering pump. Both connectors are very similar. There's a tap, you need to push it away to push the tap away if you have room. And then you can push it up. The other one is down there. Difficult to see, but it's exactly the same mechanism. When replacing the power steering pump, it's also a good idea to flush the fluid in the system, first to make the fluid clean, but also it will reduce spills when you replace the pump. I have a separate video on how to flush power steering fluid, and I'm going to link to the video here. I'm going to just suck out some fluid from the power steering reservoir so that it's easier when I disconnect the hoses. The fluid actually looks dirty. If you cannot do the flush for now, you can at least suck out the fluid from the reservoir to minimize spills. Now I'm going to disconnect the feed line. Tuck the towels under here. Without fluid in the reservoir, it's actually quite secure here. Before we remove the drive bell, while the tension is still on, we would like to loosen the bolt on the steering pump pulley. If the belt tension is not enough to keep the pulley in place while you try to take off the bolt, you may stuck a bar through the pulley to keep hold it in place. But make sure be very careful not to damage any component. Now, I also found a tool, a holder tool. This is not specifically designed for the power steering pulley, but in this case, I actually tested it and it worked very well. Can I find an angle? And this is actually quite flexible, so you can find an angle to put it in there to hold it in place. If you need more leverage, you can add a half inch drive breaker bar or ratchet to hold this in place. And then you can try to turn this counterclockwise to loosen the nut. You do not have to take the nut off. Keep it there. The pump that I got does not have the pulley, so we need to remove the pulley from the existing pump and transfer to the new pump. The next is to release the tension on the tensioner pulley so that we can remove the belt from the power steering pump pulley. Take a picture of the routing. The tensioner pulley is down there. On this Honda engine, there are actually two tensioner bolts, one in the front and then there's another one in the back. Use either one. It's also a 19 millimeter socket. Put it on. Counterclockwise to release the tension. And then once the tension is released, you can take off the pulley. And now you can release it. Use a bungee cord. Keep the belt in place so that it doesn't get in the way. Let's look at the new pump. There are two bolts that we need to loosen in order to remove the pump. These are 12 millimeters. Another 12 millimeter down there. I should have removed the high pressure line first. 10 millimeter. Again, when you remove the high pressure line, be careful not to damage the fitting. And then put it aside.
It's out. Now, we should be able to remove the entire pump.
This is loose. It should be easy to take the pulley off. Dump the fluid and take a look at the old pump, which I used to replace the factory pump 5 years ago. It has lasted for over 45,000 miles. But recently, I noticed the steering pump is heavy, especially in the morning. This is what I got from Amazon. And the listed price is about $60. What I want to do here today is just to see whether this is actually going to hold up or not, and then how long it's going to work. Another common problem on these pumps is due to the O-rings on the inlet and outlet. Let's take a look. Very important that this O-ring is good. Otherwise, you will have a leak and it's going to also suck air into the system and you are going to have lots of bubbles. While the pump is running, look at the reservoir to see if you have lots of air bubbles in there. And there's also likely a whining sound as part of it. So in that case, just get an O-ring from Honda and replace it. Let's take off the pulley. £3.85. Now the new pump, £3.05. So there are about 3 ounces different. 2 long bolts to secure the power steering pump to the engine. Can put this back. I'm going to thread this on first. And then this one at the bottom. 17 pound-feet of torque. Now I'm going to reconnect, remove the cover, and reconnect the higher pressure line. Tighten these to 8 pound-feet or 96 inch pounds. Very light, do not over torque. Good. Now I'm going to put this pulley back and this is the orientation. Tighten this to 48 pound-feet of torque. This is a big helper. Now, hopefully your drive belt or serpentine belt has not moved at all. Let's try to put it back by releasing first the tension. So this is what I would do. I will put part of the belt on, kind of half engaged. And then while I push this toward the back, I should be able to pull it up. An OE port is always the best. Today, it's an experiment to try this pump. I'm going to run it, test it, and if it works out okay, after a year, 2 years, I'm going to recommend. But at this point, I'm going to see how it works. Remove the protective cover on the new pump. And now I'm going to remove this power steering reservoir and hose back. I'm going to secure the reservoir back into place and then make sure I have the correct orientation and positioning and put this back on. Can you put the clamp back?
So make sure it's exactly in the same position
from where you removed it.
So it's going to create a tight seal.
Now, let's fill the power steering fluid. It's okay to overfill it a little bit more because it's going to go down after you start the engine. Now double check everything is in place and we We're going to start the engine and give it a test. Moment of truth. I think overall the steering is very light, which is great. With the front of the car jacked up, or you have something under the tire to protect the tires. And you want to do this a number of times to get the air out of the system.
On the power steering pump, the factory pump lasted 120,000 miles. It was replaced with the remanufacture unit from BBP Industries, which lasted already 45,000 miles. This replacement, as I said, is an experiment using a non-brand aftermarket part to evaluate its reliability. As a precaution, I will keep the BBP pump, some fluid, and necessary tools in the trunk for emergencies. My final recommendation is to always use OE ports if it's within a budget. And I understand because in my own case, 5 years ago, the OE port from Honda was really too expensive. And so I found the BBP industry unit and I was really happy with it. It's all done for today. I hope you found this video to be helpful and informative. If you did, consider giving us a thumbs up and subscribing to Professor's Garage. If Professor can do it, you can do it. Until next time, may the Lord bless you and give you peace. 平安